Zazzy, the future. Let me show you what's next. Let me show you what's next. What's next, what's next? Let me show you what's next. You watching this? Let me show you what's next. What's next, what's next? You watching this? Let me show you what's next.
Welcome to Connect. It is really good to be in person with all of you. It has been quite a bit since we've done one of these live. It's really fun to be in person. So we have a lot of exciting stuff that we're going to talk about today. We have Quest 3 and some other new hardware that I'm excited to show you. And we have a whole lot of new AI experiences. So we've been in the lab for a while, and I'm really looking forward to showing you what we've been building. But first, I just want to take a moment to talk about why we're here. At Meta, we are focused on building the future of human connection. And what that means is that we build products to help people feel closer, like we're right there, present with each other, with our friends and family and colleagues and the people we care about, no matter where in the world we actually are. And we do this because we believe that that strengthens our relationships. It helps us have more fun together. It improves how we learn. It gives us more opportunities that help span distance. Now, the physical world around us is amazing, right? I think that one of life's great joys is getting to go out and be active and explore. And at the same time, over the last few decades, our industry has been building up this increasingly vibrant digital world alongside it with all the apps and digital content that we've been creating. And I always find it funny when people say that the digital world and all the apps and stuff isn't the real world, because I think increasingly, in our modern time, the real world is really this combination of the physical world that we inhabit and this digital world that we're building. But even though we constantly are touching the digital world, it's mostly through screens, and it's almost like it inhabits a completely different plane from our physical lives. And I think that one of the most interesting questions for our industry over the coming decades is going to be, how do we unify these experiences of the physical that we have with this vibrant digital world to create something that is more coherent and just better than anything that we have today? Now, in the future, I think not too far from now, you're going to walk into a room, and there are going to be as many holograms of digital things for you to interact with as there are physical objects. I mean, think about all the things that are physically there that don't actually need to be physical things, right? All the paper, the media, the games, the art, your workstation, any screen, can all be interactive holograms. Think about going and hanging out with your friends. Pretty soon, I think we're going to be at a point where you're going to be there physically with some of your friends, and others will be there digitally as avatars, as holograms, and they'll feel just as present as everyone else. Or you'll walk into a meeting and you'll sit down at a table and you'll be there with your, there will be people who are there physically and people who are there digitally as holograms, but also sitting around the table with you are going to be a bunch of AIs who are embodied as holograms who are helping you get different stuff done too. So, this is just a quick glimpse of the future and how these ideas of the physical and digital come together into this idea that we call the metaverse. And a lot of the foundational technologies to enable this are the things that we are going to talk about today. Mixed reality allows you to bring digital objects into the physical world. advances in AI allow us to create different AIs and personas that can help us accomplish different things. And smart glasses are going to eventually allow us to bring all of this together into a stylish form factor that we can wear all day long. Now, a big part of this innovation is about making sure that these technologies are accessible to everyone. Right? Sometimes we innovate by releasing something that has never been seen before. We do that a lot. But sometimes we innovate by taking something that is awesome but is super expensive and making it so that it can be affordable for everyone or even free. And innovation to bring the future to millions or eventually billions of people is a big part of what we do, and I think that that's really important too. All right, so with that all said, let's jump right in. First, we are incredibly proud to introduce Quest 3, the first mainstream mixed reality headset. Quest 3 is it's the most powerful headset that we have ever shipped, and it allows you to blend the physical and digital worlds together. You can navigate it with just your hands if you want, and the hand tracking is getting really good, or with these brand new precision controllers that we've designed for games or work or things that where you want some extra precision. And, you know, of course, it's completely standalone. No wires, no battery pack, you know, nothing like that that's going to break your sense of presence. So when you put on Quest 3, you see the physical room around you. Only now it is a canvas that you can bring your digital objects into the world. You know, Quest 3, it understands your space so you can play with the world around you. You can solve Lego puzzles, or you can build your own creations on any flat surface in your room. You can play games like BAM with your friends sitting around a table, whether you're physically right there together, or even if they're far away. You know, people love working out in Quest. But now, if you're doing a body combat workout, the targets are going to come at you in your physical room, whether you're in your living room or if you're in your home gym. You're be able to look around and see the room around you, so you're going to be a lot more comfortable, you know, swinging your arms and moving your body. The limits of your physical space are going to be able to expand. So you're going to be able to be a part of much larger worlds. You know, there's one point in the Stranger Things game where you can be sitting in your living room or anywhere else, and portals to the Upside Down open right there. Now, these experiences are possible because Quest 3 shows your physical space with 10 times more pixels than what we had on Quest 2. And it automatically maps the space that you're in using two dedicated color camera sensors and a depth sensor, which makes it so that if you pick up a digital ball and throw it at the physical wall, it'll bounce off it. Or if someone's shooting at you and you want to duck the fire, you can just get behind your physical couch. Now, this also means that you're going to be able to take a big virtual screen and just drop it wherever you are, and it'll show up in your physical room. And this is going to unlock a lot of awesome experiences for hanging out with people, watching content, and even if they're not there with you. Now, one thing that I'm pretty excited to share today is that Xbox Cloud Gaming is coming to Quest in December. So you're going to be able to play hundreds of Xbox games, including titles like Halo and Minecraft and Elder Scrolls, and you're going to be able to do that on a massive screen anywhere you go. Now, we're just scratching the surface of what's going to be possible when you can drop virtual objects into your physical space. And next year, we're launching something that we call Augments, which are basically persistent, spatially anchored digital objects that you can interact with. So, you can put a frame on your wall with photos and videos from Facebook and Instagram. You can put a digital portal next to your physical workout gear, so every time you walk by it, you can easily jump into a supernatural workout. So, there's a lot to do here. All right, and with mixed reality on Quest 3, the transition is seamless. So if you're in an immersive experience, you can always just double tap on your headset to get back to your physical environment, and you'll see the immersive world that you're in just melts away. You're back in your physical space. All right, I'm really excited to see what all of you do with this. I'm really excited to get this in your hands. This is going to be a game changer and a big capacity improvement for these headsets. Now, on top of this, we also have the world's best library of fully immersive content. And there are a bunch of new titles that are coming, and they take advantage of all of the new power that is in this Quest 3 headset. Because this is the first headset that is shipping with the next generation Snapdragon XR2 Gen 2 Qualcomm processor. It's got twice the graphics performance of anything we've shipped before, and we designed new pancake lenses and paired them with new displays, so the graphics performance is really stunning. So let's take a look at Asgard's Wrath 2. For the original, you needed a full gaming PC and a headset that was wired to it in order to get it to work. And the sequel runs natively on Quest 3, and it looks awesome. Assassin's Creed Nexus, finally here. Worth waiting for. I know a lot of us have been waiting for this. It looks stunning. It looks stunning. And there were a bunch of other major developers who are bringing great titles out of the Open App Lab that we have, like Roblox, which is launching today. I'm really excited for this one after taking the time to optimize it for VR. It's going to be a big deal. There's also a major live sports season coming up with X Stadium. We got fully immersive NBA games for free on us. You know, you can literally sit courtside from your couch. If you're into fighting like me, you can watch LFA or Cage Warriors from UFC Fight Pass in 180-degree 4K resolution. Pretty much the next best thing to actually being in the octagon. Well, that's pretty awesome, too. We've got a lot of awesome new Horizon content coming. Love it. Shout out to Super Rumble and Citadel, which have gone to the top of the charts of popular Horizon destinations. As you can see, the visuals continue making big steps up, and these are just some of the most fun social games that are out there. In addition to all this, there are also a bunch of tools for businesses that are coming too. You know, millions of people have used one of the hundreds of productivity and work apps on Quest. And next month, we are launching Meta Quest for Business, which is going to allow you to take mixed reality and bring it to your organization at scale. So, this is going to be compatible with Microsoft Intune, VMware Workspace ONE, Ivanti UEM. And we got Microsoft 365 also coming to Quest by the end of this year. So you're going to be able to use, the productivity apps where you can get stuff done, Word, Excel. Overall, all right, so that's a bunch of the content that's coming. There's more coming as well, but that's what I have to talk about today. I'm really excited about Quest 3. It is the most powerful headset yet with the next generation processor, better displays and optics, it's 40% thinner, a lot more comfortable, and it comes with the great new precision controllers or the awesome hand tracking that has just gotten a lot better. End to end, we have designed this thing and optimized it, the hardware stack, the software stack, so it can deliver amazing mixed reality and the world's best immersive content library. So there it is. Yeah. Yeah. All right, Quest 3, it is shipping on August 10th. You can order it today for $499. All right, now, when I just think about this stuff, looking back, I just think it's kind of wild that, you know, 5 years ago, the state of the art was you needed a big gaming PC and a headset that was wired to, and you need to set up all these sensors in order to be able to do some of this stuff. And now, you know, we're sitting here, and you can do all of this with even better resolution, plus mixed reality, take it anywhere you want for just $4.99. You know, our goal is to continue to lead in developing the state of the art on this, and also to continue leading on bringing the best devices to everyone. And I'm really proud of the progress that the team has made here. So congrats, guys. All right, now, you know, there's no real way to do this transition, so let's completely change gears and just go in a completely different direction. Let's talk about AI. So this has been an amazing year for AI. At Meta alone, we have launched AI models that can generate 3D video from text prompts, that can create sound from images, that can bring objects into VR just by looking at them, that can let you speak a different language in your own voice, and of course, a leading open source foundation model, Llama 2, all in the last 12 months. But you know, this is really just the beginning. Because if you look across the industry and if you look at what everyone is doing, you know, most people haven't yet had the chance to experience these LLMs or any of these AI advances yet. And you know, that's a thing that I think that we can help change. So today, I want to talk about some of the work that we've been doing to bring this state-of-the-art AI into the apps that billions of people use. So, we set a standard for open source language models with Llama 2. But before today, you know, we haven't talked that much about our image generation models. And you know, our team has been, you know, quietly working on these and cranking on them, and they've gotten really good. So you know, we call it EMU for Expressive Media Universe, continuing with our animal theme. And just take a look at these images. Because today we're starting to roll out a bunch of products with this in it. And it's, you know, it's they're high quality, photorealistic. But you know, one of the coolest things is that EMU generates them fast. All right, so it's not a minute. It's about 5 seconds to generate one of these. Which just makes it really fun to play with, because you can just iterate. And you know, my kids tell me it's still not fast enough, but we're you know, it's, but 5 seconds kind of gets to the point where you're really cooking. All right, so we built this into chats, and we'll get to that in a moment. But first, let's talk about stickers. Because every day, people send hundreds of millions of stickers to express things in chats. And you know, every chat is a little bit different, and you want to express, you know, subtly different emotions, but you know, today we only have, you know, a fixed number, but you know, with EMU, now you have the ability to just type in what you want. You'll generate a set of custom, never-before-seen stickers on the fly, and you can send them to your friends. We've been testing this for a little bit, and people do seem to really like this. And today we're rolling it out very broadly across our different apps. In addition to stickers, we're also bringing AI editing tools to Instagram next month. So, you know, the team dug up this photo of me, you know, that turned me into a cowboy, ugly sweater party. I don't really get that one. That one's good. That, in an alternate world, you know, that could have been me. Or here's my crazy dog, Beast. Let's turn him into origami. Poor Beast. Straighten his hair, cross stitch. All right, there you go. I think this is gonna be really fun. I'm really looking forward to getting this into all of our apps, coming to Instagram in about a month. Pretty excited about this. All right, so let's move on from images for a second. You know, at Meta, one of the views that we have on the development of AI that is a little bit different from the rest of the industry is, You know, we don't think that there's going to be like one singular super intelligence that everyone interacts with. But our view is that, you know, people are going to want to interact with a bunch of different AIs for the different things that you want to do. And I actually think that over time, a lot of you are going to want to make your own AIs to advance individual goals that you have, whether you're a small business and you want to interact with customers, or if you're a creator and you want to engage your community, or whatever it is that you do. So we are building a platform for creating AIs that can help you get things done or just have fun. And you know, the way this is going to work is people are going to be able to interact with these AIs across the whole meta universe of products. So, you know, of course, you'll be able to chat with them in WhatsApp and Messenger and Instagram Direct, but beyond that, they're going to have profiles in Instagram and Facebook, and you'll be able to interact with them, and eventually they're going to be embodied as avatars and live and be able to interact with them in the metaverse too. And we're going to open this platform up for developers and more use cases soon. I'm really looking forward to seeing what all of you build. But even before that, we have been creating a bunch of AIs ourselves, and we're going to start rolling these out in beta today and ramping that a bit over the next couple of days. So let's meet some of them. All right, first up, we got Meta AI. Meta AI is your basic assistant, right? That you can talk to like a person, right? You can message Meta AI and any of the messaging apps, WhatsApp, Messenger, Instagram, Direct. Soon you're gonna be able to message it in Quest 3, and it's gonna help you, you know, answer, you know, your basic questions or requests. It is based on it's built with a model that's based on Llama 2, but in addition, it also has access to real-time information and broader knowledge through a partnership that we've done with Microsoft and Bing Search. So here you can see it, you ask a question, it has access to real-time information, it can point you towards that, it can point you towards search results. Our new image generation model, Emu, is also built directly into Meta AI. So you can just message it and tag anything with Imagine, and it will generate high-quality, photorealistic images right there in the chat in seconds. For free, so pretty excited about that. And another neat feature of this is that you can invoke Meta AI in any chat. So it doesn't just have to be Meta AI's, you know, your thread with them. You can do it in group chats, right? You just start your message with Meta AI, and it's going to respond. And we've been testing this internally, and it is really fun to just generate fun messages, photos, or you know, settle debates really quickly, or just whatever it is that you want to do. But it's super convenient. All right, so I've got Meta AI. It's our basic assistant. I think it's going to be really useful. We're going to focus over the coming months and years on building this out into a deeper and deeper personal assistant with more integrations across everything we do. And I think this is going to be a big deal. But in addition to this, we have also been experimenting with creating some AIs that are a bit more fun, or that have some more personality, opinions, interests, just a little more interactive and fun to play with. So let's check this out. So let's say you're planning dinner. You got Max the sous chef, who can help you come up with a recipe and help you come up with ideas. You know, so if you want to find a way to sneak some broccoli into your kids' dinner, Max has got you. You know, let's say you add too much salt to the recipe, he can help you balance it out. All right. Or let's say, you know, you're writing something like a keynote and you're not really sure where to get started. You can ask Lily, or personal editor AI, who can help you brainstorm and share tips, or you can give her a bunch of the text that you've written and she can help you edit it and make it better. Or maybe you're traveling and you're trying to plan a road trip with your kids. You've got Lorena, who's going to be able to help you find the best barbecue on the road trip, or find a good national park or beautiful spot to take the kids. So there you go. That's a few of them. These are just a few of the AIs that we've trained so far. There are a lot more that are coming. And they're going to span all kinds of different interests, from you know, gaming, to fashion, to philosophy, to just all kinds of fun stuff. But the important thing here is that this isn't just going to be about answering queries. Right? This is about entertainment and about helping you do things to connect with the people around you and helping you accomplish the things that you want across whatever your different goals are. And because we thought that, you know, this should feel fun and it should feel familiar, so we did something a little bit different for us. And we partnered with a bunch of pretty awesome people to basically embody these and play them. So let's say you want to get in shape. Well, this is Victor, played by Dwayne Wade. And he's going to pull together a workout plan for you and get you motivated. And you know, the good thing about Victor is he is there any time that you want to get a workout in, so you don't have to schedule a session or something like that. And he is always going to be encouraging you to hit your goals. All right, let's say you're trying to pull together Halloween costumes for your family. Well, you got Dylan, played by Lore DIY, who's got you covered on crafts. So, you know, my daughter really wanted me to be Dumbledore and kind of struggling with the beard thing, so you got Dylan and she helped me work this out. But then I got this other problem, which is my other daughter doesn't want to go with the Harry Potter theme, she just wants to be an apple. So I'm like, all right, how do I fit this into the theme? And I think that's actually a pretty good idea. So, all right, so anyhow, so that's Dylan. Okay, or let's say you want to do something a little bit wilder. Let's say you want to play a role-playing game. Well, now you can just drop the dungeon master into one of your chats, and let's check this guy out.
Let's get medieval, player.
I mean, who hasn't wanted to play a text, you know, adventure game with Snoop Dogg? Oh, man. So, it's good. The expressions are good. We've got voice coming over the couple of months, probably early next year or something like that. But this is pretty fun to play with. You know, at this point in the keynote, I was kind of thinking, you know, we could do an audible. You want a live demo?
Yeah!
All right. Can't promise much, but let's try it. Let's try it and see what happens. All right. So let's see. Where are we? Okay, which one? What do we do?
Forge ahead.
Forge ahead? It's forge ahead. Gather your weapons and armor. Well, I think we know what to do. Let's get on a horse. All right, we return to the keynote at this point. All right. The demo gods have smiled upon us. All right. So that's just a handful of some of the AIs that we're building. And there are a lot more to discover. So we put together this quick video just featuring some of the people we're working on this project with. I think this is pretty fun.
We built some AIs you can interact with and then partnered with awesome people to play some of them to make them even more fun. Introducing Meta's AIs with Tom Brady as Brew. Ready to throw you his deep knowledge of sports.
Seriously? How could you not know that?
Naomi Osaka as Tamika. Proven it's cool to geek out.
Time for a selfie.
Chris Paul as Perry. He's preaching the gospel of golf.
Drive for show, putt for dope.
Paris Hilton is Amber. She's taken a stylish bite out of crime.
Not to brag, but I am a forensic expert.
Mr. Beast is Zach. This dude's funny. Like, funny, funny.
I'm not saying I know everything.
Israel Adesanya as Luis. He'll make sure you never tap out.
The more you know, the better you can move on the mat.
Kendall Jenner as Billy. She'll always have your back.
I'll keep it real, but above all, I'll keep it on the DL.
Roy Choi is Max. Nix that delivery order. You're cooking in tonight.
Chef, what's on the menu today?
Charlie D'Amelio is Coco, making sure you and your moves aren't sus.
Hey, y'all. You ready to dance?
Snoop Dogg is Dungeon Master. Slay the games you love.
Your quest begins now, player.
So, if you're looking to explore your interests, learn a new skill, settle a debate, or just have fun, start using Meta's AIs.
All right, so this is our first effort at training a bunch of AIs that are a bit more fun. So you'll have to tell us what you think. But look, this is early stuff, right? These still have a lot of limitations, which will be apparent when you use them. Unlike the Meta AI, they don't, for the most part, have access to real-time information yet, although we're working hard to get that in. We'll get that in over the coming weeks and months. There's just a lot that we're going to continue improving and tuning as we get more feedback. But what I think you're going to see as you interact with them is that they each have unique backstories and interesting opinions that they bring to this. And that will just come out even more as they evolve over time. And I also think it's going to be fun to watch them interact with each other, too. So that's that. We're also very focused on giving all of you the ability to build AIs too. So we've been creating something that we call AI Studio. And it is a platform for building these kind of AIs. And we're starting by opening up the API for integrating into our messaging apps to start. And that's going to open in the coming weeks. We are also building a sandbox so that people who don't code can also train AIs like this. And we're working on that and iterating on it. And we hope to have that out sometime early next year. And we're also working on bringing all of this to the metaverse, too, where you're going to be able to have these AIs will be able to be embodied as avatars. You'll be able to make them as NPCs in the different games and experiences that you build and all of the different Horizon worlds, and I think that that's going to be really neat. Now, in addition to this, we're also making it so that businesses can use these, because I think that there's a very big use for businesses to want to engage with customers for commerce and support, and we're actually launching with a very small number of businesses in alpha today. We're going to focus on really dialing this in before we roll it out more broadly. I think that this is going to be a challenging optimization. So I think this is going to be a lot of the next year. We're going to be kind of focused on building this out for businesses before we release this more broadly. But I'm really excited to begin on that journey with that alpha today. We also are excited about getting this in creators' hands so that you can build AIs that represent you to help you grow your community and engage with your community. But one of the things is, as we're building that, that's what we think is going to come sometime in probably the first half of next year, because we think that getting the brand safety on that is just really critical, right? We want to make sure that if you're a creator, that you can train these AIs that way they're going to say things that just kind of reflect the way that you would want to represent your brand and your community. That's still going to require a bit of work to get there. We want to make sure we do this thoughtfully. So for this very first release, we thought it would be a little easier to start by making up some new characters rather than trying to make something that has perfect fidelity to a kind of a real creator. But we'll get there. It is important to do all of this very thoughtfully, right? Because generative AI, it's powerful. There's a lot of awesome potential. But there are also clearly going to be some new challenges that come with this too. And you know, some of these challenges are gonna look a lot like the ones that our integrity teams have gotten world-class at, and a lot of experience dealing with those kind of challenges over the last set of years. But there are also undoubtedly gonna be some new challenges too. And we've tried to think about this in advance and brainstorm as to what these would be and build as many safeguards in as we can. We've been training and fine-tuning the models to fit our safety and responsibility guidelines. We've done a lot of red teaming with experts on this. We've been building guardrails around inappropriate conversations. And of course, we share the system cards for all these systems publicly, so that way people can look at what the systems do and how they work and can give us feedback on that. We're also taking the step of rolling this stuff out a bit more slowly than we normally would. So that way, as issues come up, as we're rolling this out, we can address them before we get to scale. And overall, we're really focused on making sure that this technology will be beneficial to our lives and additive to our social interactions, because that's what we're here to do. I'm really optimistic about this. I mean, I think that this is going to enable a wide range of new use cases. I mean, some of the stuff that we showed today, but a lot more to come too. And I think that this is just going to transform how people use all of our products, from feeds to chat to all the metaverse stuff to virtual and augmented reality. I think it's going to change how businesses and creators think about these platforms too. And one area that I am especially interested to see is how the advances in AI intersect with advances in building the next computing platform. So that brings me to the last thing that I want to show you today, which is the next generation of Ray-Ban Meta smart glasses. Now, these are designed so you can stay in the moment and stay connected without having to take your phone out. You can capture what's going on around you. You can share with your friends in the world. Everything about this is upgraded from the first version. The cameras are a lot better, so the images and videos that you capture are a lot clearer. The audio is a lot better, so when you're listening to music or podcasts or taking calls, that's a lot better. They're lighter, they're more comfortable, and there are a lot more styles too. But the most interesting thing about this isn't any of those specs. It's that these are the first smart glasses that are built and shipping with Meta AI in them. So starting in the US, you're going to get this state-of-the-art AI that you can interact with hands-free wherever you go. So, let's say you're grilling with your family and you want to know how long you need to be cooking that chicken for, or you're playing pickleball and hits the line and you want to know if that's a fault. She disagrees, but you know the truth. Or let's say you just want to settle a debate, some trivia as you're going out through the world. Just ask your Ray-Ban Meta glasses, and they'll respond and get you the answer. And the thing is that this is just the beginning, right? Because this is just audio. It's basically text. Starting next year, we're going to be issuing a free software update to the glasses that makes them multimodal. So the glasses are going to be able to understand what you're looking at when you ask them questions. So if you want to know what the building is that you're standing in front of, or if you want to translate a sign that's in front of you to know what it's saying, or if you need help fixing this sad, leaky faucet, you can basically just talk to Meta AI and look at it, and it'll walk you through it step by step how to do it. So that's, I think that smart glasses are going to be an important platform for the future. Not only because they're the natural way to put holograms in the world, so we can put digital objects, in our physical space, but also because if you think about it, smart glasses are the ideal form factor for you to let an AI assistant see what you're seeing and hear what you're hearing. And before this last year's AI breakthroughs, I kind of thought that smart glasses were only really going to become ubiquitous once we really dialed in, the holograms and the displays and all of that stuff, which we're making progress on, but is somewhat longer. But now, you know, I think that the AI part of this is going to be just as important in smart glasses being widely adopted as any of the other augmented reality features. Now, before even any of these AI advances came up, we'd started planning this product. And before all of that, we built in one more feature into these smart glasses that we thought would be pretty awesome. And that is that for the first time, you are going to be able to live stream to your friends and followers from your glasses. So, and I was chatting about this with Rocco, who is the head of wearables at our partner in making these, Essilor Luxottica. And I asked him, like, hey, do you have any ideas for who would be a good person to take these for a test drive? And I think he had a good idea, so let's go check this out.
Hey, Meta. Call Charles.
Calling Charles on WhatsApp.
Hey, Rocco.
Ciao, Charles. How you doing?
All good. And you?
Good, good. Did you get the glasses we sent you?
Yeah. I'm trying the glasses now for the first time.
I can't wait to see your point of view.
Thanks to you, Rocco. It was great to catch up, and I'm going to take this for a test drive now. Ciao. Hey, Meta. Take a video.
Let's try some music.
We are here live at the track. Everybody is ready to race, and I am getting ready too. Let's go.
Switching to glasses.
Hey Meta, if I became a race car driver, what would my nickname be? Rocco the Rocket. Not bad.
All right, so being able to share, you know, what you're doing live with your friends and followers while staying completely in the moment is the kind of thing that you can only do on smart glasses. So, all right, these Ray-Ban Meta smart glasses, we're launching them on October 17th, starting at $299, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what you all think of them. Okay, so this has been a busy year. All right, and those are the main things that I wanted to share with you. A little long, but hopefully worth it. We've got Quest 3, the first mainstream mixed reality headset and the most powerful headset that we have ever shipped. Yeah. We've got AI Studio giving you the ability to interact with and soon build your own set of AIs for assistance, entertainment, and just getting things done, interacting with people in a fun way in the way that you would online. AI Studio. And we've got Ray-Ban Meta smart glasses, the next generation of the glasses with better camera and audio, and the first smart glasses with Meta AI built in. And you know, as all this technology keeps developing, I just keep going back to this question that I asked up front about, for the future of human connection, how are we going to weave together the wonderful physical world that we have with this vibrant digital world that we're building into something that is better than we have today? And I think you can start to see from some of these building blocks that we're talking about today how this is going to come together. Mixed reality unlocks the ability to put digital objects into the physical world. Advances in AI allow us to create different AI personas to help us get different things done. And smart glasses are making progress towards eventually integrating all these technologies into something that we can wear anywhere, wherever we go. But to build The future, it's not just enough to make this possible, we have to make it so that it is affordable and accessible to everyone. And that's why we focus a lot of our innovation, not just on the groundbreaking innovations, but on making sure that these things are going to be accessible to everyone. Because to us, that is just as important as advancing the state of the art. So now, as we begin the next chapter here, as we get these all in your hands, I think a lot of the fun really begins, because we get to see all the energy and creativity that all of you are going to bring to this, to see what is possible. As always, it is an honor to be on this journey building this with you. Thank you all for coming out to Connect. And now I'm going to hand it over to our Chief Technology Officer, Boz. Thank you.
All right, we got mixed reality, artificial intelligence, smart glasses. It's a fun time to see the future taking shape right before our eyes. And we're going to bring these futuristic technologies to market, just like Mark said, to the mass market in a way that nobody else can. So let's take a deeper dive into each of those, starting with Quest. Now, we can't talk about Quest 3 without recognizing what made it possible. Quest 2, first announced here at Connect in 2020, and it was a game changer for the industry, not just for us. I mean, it set the standard for what a modern headset should be. It's the device that introduced VR to the mainstream. It helped tens of millions of people have their first experience of this future. And now, 3 years later, Quest 3 is the beginning of the next wave. It builds on all the things that people love about Quest 2, but it also brings something completely new to the mass market: mixed reality. This new headset still enables all the immersive VR experiences that people love on Quest, but it can also deliver new experiences that blend your physical and your digital environments together. This isn't one or the other. It can do both. Sometimes you want to be fully immersed, and sometimes you want to see everything that's happening around you, augmented with digital objects, and sometimes it'll even be both at the same time. Games can now incorporate your surroundings into the gameplay. And if you're watching live sports, it can transition from your own immersive private theater to a big screen on your living room wall. And wherever you are, all you have to do is double tap the side of the headset to switch between a fully immersive space and a blended environment. You experience the difference mixed reality brings from the very moment you put on your Quest 3, because the first thing you see is the world around you. But to enhance that full color pass-through on the Quest 3, we've increased the resolution, we've improved the color accuracy, we've reduced distortions and latency. And you're not just seeing a live video feed of the space that you're in. Quest 3 can understand your space and blend it with the virtual world. That begins with understanding where it's safe for you to move around. That's right, no more manually setting up your PlayStation boundary. Woo! Quest 3 does that automatically. This extends to room capture, so it automatically maps your space and understands elements like walls, furniture, and objects. Once they're mapped, they become a part of your virtual environment too. This makes a lot of new experiences possible. Games can bring your surroundings into their gameplay, so in first encounters, an alien spaceship descends from your ceiling and lands on your coffee table. And next year, you'll be able to customize your space with a library of augments that interact with the world in ways that physical objects can't. These can be dynamic 3D objects or 2D displays, and they can all exist together in the same space. You can size, place, and spatially anchor augments, so every time you put on your headset, they're right where you left them. Augments can blend parts of your favorite VR experiences into the world around you. You can keep Beat Saber trophies on your shelf, place life-size artifacts from games like Population One or Asgard's Wrath in your living room, or you can bring your favorite artists and stations to life with interactive music players from iHeartRadio. I mean, we're just getting started with what you'll be able to do to enhance your world with augmented reality. Some of the best new titles coming to Quest 3 take advantage of this mixed reality capability, and you'll hear about those in a few minutes. Now, as Mark mentioned, this is the most powerful Quest we've ever made because it's the world's first device to feature Qualcomm's new Snapdragon XR2 Gen 2 platform. And the Quest developers that we have already building on Quest 3 have told us that this chipset has let them push graphics and gameplay to places that have not been possible until now. You will feel the power immediately when you take out an app that has already been optimized to take advantage of what Quest 3 is capable of. And it does all of this, by the way, on a standalone headset. No wires, no battery pack, no console to plug into. We've also made big improvements to the display and the optics stack. This is a new display system and a new generation of the same pancake lenses that we debuted on Quest Pro last year. The result is an almost 30% increase in resolution. Those pancake lenses are also one of the reasons we've been able to slim down the Quest 3. It's a lot more comfortable to wear, thanks to this thin profile and more even weight distribution. The controller's got an upgrade too. You can say goodbye to the tracking ring. This allows for a much slicker, more ergonomic design that feels like a natural extension of your hand. And of course, speaking of hands, that's another great way to use your Quest 3. With hand tracking and a new direct touch system, you can put down your controllers and interact with Quest in the same way that you would a touchscreen. We've also got an all-new range of accessories. For the first time, you can choose from multiple color options for your facial straps and interface. And there's a great new charging dock, too. Starting at $499, this is going to be the best value spatial computing headset on the market for a long time to come. But just being the best headset doesn't mean all that much without all the things that you can do on it. So next up, we're going to talk about all the great content coming to Quest 3. Thank you.
Hey guys, it's Manuel here, and I'm gonna try the Quest 3 for the first time.
Yo, it's Tech Man Ju. Let's hop into Quest 3.
Let's get it.
Ready?
I got you.
Okay, come here.
Let's get it.
Engage in warm up mode.
Rolling. We are warm and ready to go.
This is anything right there. Look at my goodness.
Now this is going to be fun.
It is so great to see so many of you in the audience here in Menlo Park today. We are so proud of what Quest 2 has done to shape an entire industry. And for me, the single most important thing it did was help our community of developers reach a massive audience of people hungry for the best titles. Quest developers have built the strongest VR ecosystem in the world. And the numbers speak for themselves. Over $2 billion have been spent on games and apps in the Quest store. Yeah. As a result, developers of all sizes are growing and sustaining their businesses. And now, after almost a decade of bringing world-class immersive titles to VR, we're working with our developer community to pioneer yet another new frontier in mixed reality. We've made great progress. More than 100 new and upgraded titles are coming to Quest 3 this year, and more than half of those will showcase mixed reality features. But this is just the beginning. While we're excited to share what's possible in mixed reality today, it's going to be developers who will define this next era for our industry, just like you did with VR. So Quest 3 begins with an incredible foundation, the entire Quest library. And it will look better and play better thanks to next-generation hardware. Let's check out some games. Take a look here at The Walking Dead, Saints and Sinners. You can see how Skydance was able to add more detail to the scenes, take advantage of increased draw distances, and boost the overall resolution of their textures. Quest 3 provides improved processing power so you can choose the features and improvements that your players will be the most excited about. Another great example, Asgard's Wrath 2, which we announced at the Quest Gaming Showcase. It's an amazing game. Visceral combat, massive epic scale environments, and gorgeous visuals that take advantage of Quest 3's improved performance. Asgard's Wrath 2 is coming to Quest 2, Quest Pro, and Quest 3 on December 15th. And we've got a special surprise for Quest 3 buyers. Asgard's Wrath 2 is included free with your purchase. Why do I have a feeling a bunch of us are going to call in sick that day? There are many more big games coming. To name a few, we've got Assassin's Creed, Ghostbusters, Stranger Things VR, and Sega's Samba de Amigo. And Roblox will make it easy to create, publish, and distribute experiences in VR. As Mark said, the launch of Xbox Cloud Gaming means hundreds of the best titles from the Xbox ecosystem will be playable on Quest. With so many titles to choose from, we want to make it easy for everyone to discover the best games. Quest Plus is our new subscription service that delivers two hand-picked games from the ever-growing Quest library each month. In October, subscribers will get access to Onward and Little Cities. And if you buy the 512-gig model of Quest 3, it comes with a free 6-month subscription to Quest Plus. We're also bringing some great new games to Horizon Worlds, which can now support improved experiences like Super Rumble, a first-person shooter that launched in July, and Citadel, an adventure game that launched this month. Games like these are built to be social from the ground up. So we've made it easier to get together with friends and jump straight into a world. Social experiences are growing fast on Quest, especially when combined with games. And we want every developer to have the option to add social features to their titles. So we're committed to expanding the social connective tissue of the Quest platform over the coming year. We'll make it easier to find and meet up with friends and travel together to a destination, whether it's a multiplayer game or a virtual world. Here you can see me joining my crew for a Super Rumble session. Once we're all together, it's easy to jump straight into the game. Obviously, my avatar with the two-tone blue hair. And this is another way we're improving our social features. I look more like myself because our avatars can represent a much wider range of people. We have more options for body types, makeup and face paint, hair color, and more. And because Horizon Worlds now works on web and mobile, the social element is even better. You can meet up with your friends no matter what device everyone is on. Moving on to fitness and wellness, another place where developers have discovered a Quest superpower that millions of people love. And now with mixed reality, even more is possible. With Les Mills Body Combat, you can turn your home into your virtual gym. Feel the freedom to move, hit targets, and dodge walls, all while working up a sweat and having fun with your favorite coaches. Quest 3's advanced resolution makes Supernatural even more stunning and vibrant, work out in environments like the Galapagos Islands that look more real than ever before. And the Within team is working hard to make fitness accessible to more people. Supernatural is now only $9.99 per month starting today. There are so many great exercise options on Quest, whether it's a boxing class or interval training. And now, one of the world's most popular fitness programs is coming. FitXR will bring Zumba classes to VR for the first time. Also coming soon, Quest 3 will have reimagined wellness experiences from Headspace. They've built a great app that uses the immersion of VR to help you be more mindful. Trust me, this is the app I need most right now. Quest 3 turns any space into an awesome immersive home theater and offers entertainment that you can't get anywhere else. X Stadium is streaming immersive NBA games and League Pass. Subscribers can check out multi-game mode, which lets you watch multiple NBA games at once. And if consuming cheese and crackers is more your sport, you can hang out with your new roommates, Wallace and Gromit. Or sit front row, catch your favorite artists perform at Red Rocks and iHeartRadio live concerts. And you can watch videos on YouTube VR, or movies, TV, and sports from streaming apps like Peacock and Pluto TV. There's also some big new updates for getting work done. For companies that want to deploy Quest, we have a wide range of business-critical work apps like Adobe Substance 3D Modeler, which allows you to sculpt in 3D, in VR, on desktop, or between both surfaces. Microsoft Mesh for Teams is entering public preview. The pharmaceutical company, Takeda, is using it to offer employees immersive experiences that facilitate onboarding and collaboration and help create a sense of belonging. Speaking of more big launches in the works, later this year, you'll be able to leverage your favorite Microsoft 365 productivity apps like Word, PowerPoint, and Excel. And coming soon, Windows 365 will offer a new way to securely stream the Windows experience to your MetaQuest device, including personalized apps, content, and settings. On top of this, next month we're launching the number one thing that businesses have asked for, MetaQuest for Business. It comes with user, app, and device management, plus enterprise-grade consumer support. Quest 3 is coming with an immense offering of original titles, and some of the best immersive experiences are joined by titles that explore the incredible potential of mixed reality. We couldn't have done any of this without the amazing community of developers who have redefined what's possible on Quest. Honestly, the best part about my job is getting to work so closely with so many of you here today. And I can tell you that Meta's commitment to this community is stronger than ever. Just like we're continuing to build VR together, we're excited to be at the beginning of this next great wave of innovation in our industry. And we can't wait to build the future with you. Thank you.
and I'm off of the charts. Ow. I'm all about the hype. I'm all about the hype. I'm all about the hype.
I'm all about the hype.
Can help you stay connected to the people you care about while remaining present in the world around you. We started this journey in 2021 when we launched Ray-Ban Stories with our amazing partner, EssilorLuxottica. This enabled us to see the potential of smart glasses put into action. People have created millions of moments of connection with our glasses. We learned so much about what they love the most and what they want us to improve. We heard all of your feedback, and we thank you for it because it has helped us redesign the new generation of smart glasses from the inside out. We are so excited today to introduce you to the new Ray-Ban Meta Smart Glasses Collection. Yes! People really love to be able to capture photos and videos without the need to pull out their phone. With smart glasses, you no longer have to choose between capturing the moment or truly experiencing it. First up, the new ultra-wide 12-megapixel camera takes beautiful photos and 1080p video. With a powerful new processor and Meta's enhanced computational photography, we have better image processing, video stabilization, and much faster performance. These new glasses also comes with 8x the memory. With 32 gigs, you can now store over 100 videos and 500 photos right there in your glasses. But check it out for yourself. Here's some of the amazing pictures and videos that my fantastic teammates have taken. We've been testing these glasses over the last few months. Now, I'm clearly not as cool as my teammates. I don't go skydiving every day. I'm mostly taking pictures and videos of my cats. Chipotle and Adobo. I think these are great pictures. And Chipotle and Adobo Miller are definitely cool cats. We have also made it easier to seamlessly share photos. If I want to send a picture of Chipotle to my best friend Heidi, all I have to do is to say, "Hey Meta, send a photo to Heidi." The glasses will take a fantastic photo and send it directly to my BFF Heidi in the app where we usually chat, all without me having to take out my phone. Now let's get back to video. Video recordings, they don't just look better thanks to the awesome camera. They sound better because we've added 5 microphones spread around the glasses. This microphone array, it lets you record immersive audio when capturing videos. It means you can relive the moment in surround sound exactly as you experienced it. Whether it is your dog barking in front of you, your cats meowing behind you, your kids screaming to the left, and your partner yelling to the right, truly immersive video to capture your memories. This mic array, it also helps you make the best
hands-free calling experience. Your voice comes through crystal clear, even in windy or noisy environments. Another thing that people really loved about their glasses was the speakers. And we knew this was a place that we could deliver an even better experience this generation. We have completely redesigned our custom speakers to have 50% higher max volume, and we doubled the bass. Yeah. Boom! We have also improved directional audio to help reduce audio leakage. So it's only you listening to your tunes. Yeah. But all of this technology, it only matters when you're actually wearing the glasses. So, we put in a lot of work to make them even more stylish and comfortable than ever before. Yeah! We have been able to make them lighter. We have rebalanced the weight. The frames are slimmer and it's more flexible, all for a more comfortable fit. You can still get the iconic Ray-Ban Meta Wayfarer in standard and large sizes. But now, they are joined by the all-new Ray-Ban Meta Headliner. Yeah! Check out the curves. It's rounded, it's retro, it's classic. We wanted to celebrate the awesome tech and the oomph that we have packed into these glasses. So check out the new options for transparent frames. You can get them in caramel, in jeans, and in rebel black. But of course, you can still get them in the classic matte black and shiny black too. And with the Ray-Ban Remix platform, now you can fully customize and personalize your choice of frames and lenses with more than 150 different combinations. Woo! All of this goodness, it comes in a gorgeous new charging case that is slimmer and 32% lighter. It looks like the iconic Ray-Ban case, and it gives you 8 additional chargers for up to 36 total hours of use. Yeah! And beyond all of this, we've also got some totally new features coming to smart glasses for the first time ever. Live streaming. Creators are always looking for better ways to share their point of view. And live streaming from your glasses is a truly unique way to let your followers see what you're seeing in real time and let them participate in your experience. You can stay focused on what you are best at, and your followers, they can see it all from your perspective. Let's check out how easy it is to live stream from your glasses. Simply start your live from Instagram or Facebook the way you always do. A glasses icon will automatically show up right there in the app. When you double-click on your glasses, you immediately switch from your phone camera to your glasses camera. You can toggle back and forth throughout your live stream. And to keep you present and in the moment, a simple touch and hold on the side of your glasses anytime. And you can hear how many people are watching you live and a readout of the most recent comment. Our smart glasses help people connect in ways that just are not possible on any other device today. We cannot wait to see what creators will share from this new perspective. The other new feature, AI. As Mark mentioned earlier, we have been working to bring the power of AI into all of our products. And starting in the US, smart glasses will be our first device with Meta AI built in. Meta AI can help you be more creative. It can inspire you with new ideas, and it can deliver you useful information. And it does it all on the go, hands-free. Let me share with you how I personally use this. So I'm great at taking videos of my cat, Chipotle, Adobo, but I'm not as good at writing funny captions for Instagram. So when I take a video like this with my glasses and I want to share it, I can ask Meta AI to help me out with what to say. Hey Meta, write me a funny caption for my cat Adobo running on his wheel.
Adobo the cat, where exercise meets existential crisis. Hashtag cats of Instagram. Hashtag cat wheel.
Existential crisis indeed. Now that my cat has had his workout, it's my turn. I love spending time in Sedona. And when I'm there, I'm always taking impromptu hikes. When I'm on the move though, Meta AI can help me come up with ideas for where to go. Hey Meta, what's a short hike in Sedona that has gorgeous views?
A nice short hike with beautiful views in Sedona is the Cathedral Rock Trail, a moderate climb offering stunning red rock formations and breathtaking vistas.
Meta AI makes your smart glasses a whole lot smarter. And it's going to get even more powerful with real-time search capabilities. Soon, you'll be able to get up-to-date information on nearly anything, restaurants, hotels, points of interest, and news. And on top of being able to speak to Meta AI, soon you're going to be able to show it things using the camera. If I'm out on my hike and I see something interesting like this, I can simply ask Meta AI to tell me about what it is that I'm looking at. Based on the image from the camera, it can give me the answer.
This is the Chapel of the Holy Cross. It was commissioned by local sculptor Marguerite Brunswick Staud and inspired by the Empire State Building.
As our AI models get more powerful, your glasses will get more and more useful. And we all know this. AI is getting better fast. We think you're going to love all the different things that you can do with these glasses. They're loaded with better tech and new features, and the price still starts at $299. You can pre-order right now. And we will hit retail stores on October 17 in 15 countries. My team and I, we truly had a blast building this for you. And from the bottom of our hearts, we know you are going to love this. Cheers.
That's
it.
Oh, we are live. Wow, these are dope.
Hey, Meta. Call Eric.
Calling Eric.
Yo, what's up?
Yo, Eric. Yeah, let's go with the silk.
Hey, Meta. Send a photo to Mom on WhatsApp. Say cheese. Cute.
Hey, Meta. What mocktail pairs well with an avocado pesto pasta?
A refreshing cucumber lime mocktail pairs well with avocado pesto pasta.
Wow, that's fire.
What does it sound like?
It's like all around me.
Hey, Meta. Take a video.
All right, let's go.
You look good.
What else can these do?
It's been an incredible year in AI, both for the industry and here at Meta. Earlier this year, we introduced our family of large language models named Llama to researchers. And we received overwhelming interest, not only from that community, but also from developers and companies who were all seeking an open model for innovation control. So in July, we released Llama 2, our next generation with open access for the industry. And the response has blown us away. Since releasing Llama, we've seen a lot of momentum and innovation with more than 30 million downloads. And 10 million of those were just in the last 30 days. Yeah. And the open source community has also really embraced our models. They fine-tuned and released over 7,000 derivatives. And on average, across standard benchmarks, they've improved our performance by nearly 10%. We've also added industry partners like IBM, Cloudflare, and Google Cloud. And today, we're thrilled to announce an expanded relationship with Amazon Web Services as our first managed API partner for Llama 2. So now organizations of all sizes can access our models on Amazon Bedrock, where it's going to be easy to get started, customize, and integrate Llama into any application using just an API key. Now, we've made a lot of progress, but our journey with Llama is just beginning. We're continuing to invest in the next generation of AI models, and I look forward to telling you more about Llama 3 next year. So let's talk about today and how we're leveraging technology from Llama 2 alongside research advancements we've made in other areas like image generation to deliver some of the experiences that Mark introduced earlier. Let's talk about our conversational AIs first. Everyone speaks differently, and truly conversational AIs will need to as well. We wanted our AIs to feel engaging and not robotic. So we took this into account when we were building on top of Llama 2 to create our initial set of AIs. The first thing we did was create specialized data sets that are anchored in natural conversation. This helped us refine our model so our AIs respond in a conversational and friendly tone. Next, we lengthened our model context to improve performance so that our AIs are capable of these deeper back and forth chats rather than these short threads. And last, we optimized our output length for different form factors like mobile or smart glasses so that our AIs won't give you a novel when you just need a sentence. And as Mark mentioned, we also created the AI Studio, which is a platform for creating and testing and sharing AIs across the company and our products. This platform also enabled us to build our AIs in a safer and more responsible way. If you've spent any time playing with conversational AIs, you probably know that they have the potential to say things that are inaccurate or even inappropriate. And that can happen with ours too. This is why we've taken many steps to mitigate those challenges by building responsibly and prioritizing safety from the very start. This includes following our own responsible use guidelines that we opened publicly with Llama 2. We established strong safety layers on the inputs and outputs of our models. We spent thousands of hours red teaming our AIs with experts. And red teaming is an iterative process where you try to get the model to say harmful things, then apply fixes and repeat. We're also releasing system cards alongside our AI so we can be transparent and people can understand what's inside and how they were built. Large language models are amazing pieces of technology, and you can integrate them with other software services like search engines and trip planners or even code interpreters. And with Meta AI, we saw an opportunity to take this capability and create an assistant that can do more than just write poems. So behind Meta AI, we built an orchestrator. And it can seamlessly detect a user's intent from a prompt and route it to the right extension. And the first extension we're making available is web search. So if your query requires real-time information, Meta AI will automatically ask Bing to get you the answer. Whether you want to know the history of Eggs Benedict, or how to make it, or even where to get it from San Francisco, Meta AI can help ensure you have access to the most up-to-date information through the power of search. Now, our conversations can happen in ways that go beyond words. Pictures and images have become a huge part of how we chat. That's why we integrated an image generation model called Emu into Meta AI. And with Emu, we can now create beautiful, high-resolution images in just 5 seconds. Outside of Meta AI, we took Emu and we used it to create new visual experiences across our products, starting with stickers. And stickers have become a huge form of communication, with billions of them shared each month across our apps. We wanted to take this extremely popular feature and reimagine it with AI to provide people infinitely more options for self-expression. And one of the cool things behind AI stickers is that it leverages both our language and our image generation models. And combining these modalities helped us improve the style, the diversity, and even quality of what we could create. And our AI stickers are really fast. It only takes about 3 seconds on average to generate multiple options that you can share instantly. Okay, people love taking photos and sharing them across our platforms. Our AI media editing tools will let you do that in new ways. And we call them Backdrop and Restyle. And they're coming soon to Instagram in the US. With Restyle, you can create a new dimension of visual flair to your photos. By just saying a simple word or phrase, you can now reimagine or create any filter that you can think of. So if you feel like infusing, you know, a cozy vibe, you can type crochet. Or if you want to add a more artistic look, you can just type watercolor. And Restyle makes this really easy. And with Backdrop, it leverages one of our most popular model releases from this year, Segment Anything. And it can cut out any object in any image with just a single tap. So now, you can reimagine your background and change the scene with just a few taps. I might type something like surrounded by puppies, and this feature will give me an entirely new story for my photo. All right, so I covered some of our new AI products and features and some of the technology that's powering them. You know, it's early days, and we are just getting started. We've worked hard to build this amazing foundation. So on behalf of the whole team, we can't wait to see what you all do with this. Thank you.
I've been trying to drag my friends out to experience this. So I turned to Meta AI for some help. Imagine a picnic overlooking a gorgeous sunset on a mountain. Who can resist? Everybody needed a little help doing some last-minute planning. Look at us now. Success. A little extra help goes a long way.
It's so great to be here to talk a little bit more about what went into building our AIs. We've taken a unique and very meta approach to creating them, and there are lots of them coming. To design the initial set, we collaborated with internal and external experts across a range of disciplines, like writers, producers, and user researchers, along with our civil rights, diversity, and technical teams, to build a set of characters that reflect the wide array of interests that people have. Whether you're looking for travel tips, gameplay, advice, or just a great conversation, these AIs offer fun and novel experiences. To create them, we used technology from Llama 2, but we reimagined what would be required to achieve an entertaining conversational experience. These foundational components of our model development process were used to build AIs that are consistent in tone and remain in character, while also being knowledgeable and engaging. Multimodality was core to bringing this experience to life. We filmed people to represent these AIs, and then had to use generative techniques to turn a bunch of disparate animations into the cohesive experience that you see today. Then we had to orchestrate it all in a way that felt seamless, bringing the chats and the visual elements together. And of course, our character development process wouldn't have been possible without careful prompt engineering, so that each character and conversation can stay true to their unique personality and tone. Now, we knew that our universe of AIs would grow, and so we made AI Studio to support this endeavor across Meta. It's designed for us to responsibly build and prompt engineer, test, benchmark, red team, and debug all of these AIs we built. And it's the central spot for deploying them and managing them too. You know, as an engineer, I'm really excited about the development velocity a platform like this can enable company-wide. And AI Studio also forms the foundation for the sandbox that we're working on, where next year, a bunch of people will be able to experiment with creating and sharing all of the AIs they've personally built. Our work with AI is just getting started. In the future, we'll see AIs adopt an even greater level of realism, embodiment, and connectedness as they move through both physical and virtual worlds, interacting both with people, but also each other. We'll also build new models for text, image, and video generation that extend into 3D and enable the creation of new objects, characters, and entire worlds within the metaverse. When you look at the innovation on display today, we're taking a significant leap forward to unlock this new set of immersive experiences. AI is shaping the way that we're building the metaverse, and in turn, the metaverse is changing the way that we think about AI, with experiences that span different modalities, form factors, and applications that seemed like science fiction only a few years ago. On behalf of our entire team, it has been super special to share these new AI experiences with you and walk you through all of the advancements that have made them possible. And now to wrap things up, here's Boz.
All right. You guys have seen a lot of exciting announcements today. Just to summarize, mixed reality, artificial intelligence, smart glasses. You guys catch all that? Working my repetition game in. This is a big year for new technology hitting the market. And it is easy to forget how far we've come in just 1 year's time, right? We now have mixed reality that can combine your physical and digital worlds. That doesn't mean it's just not possible on any other category of device. And we can do all of that while still delivering all the wonderful, fully immersive experiences that only VR can offer. You know, these headsets, they're just designed from the ground up to go mainstream and mass market. If you were at home and you were playing a drinking game to this keynote, all of it, mainstream and mass market, those are your keywords. You'd be in trouble right now, right? Like every social technology that we build, we have worked hard to make them as accessible as possible to as many people as possible. That is, and how will always be, how Meta chooses to innovate. And now, we have artificial intelligence that can help us be more expressive, more connected, and more productive. It'll make your Instagram feed more creative, make your group chats more lively, make your virtual worlds on Quest more vibrant. And all of that is built on an open source foundation that technologists around the world can build on and improve. Each one of these innovations is pretty good on its own, I think you'll agree. But when you zoom out I think you can see how they hold the promise to make something even better altogether. Our new smart glasses give you a glimpse of the way these two technological pathways eventually intersect, right? The glasses take some of the most fundamental parts of our digital and physical lives and bring them together. Digital lives, things like taking a photo and sharing it with friends, right? And the physical life of being present with people, and they integrate them together. So instead of choosing between, you know, staying connected and being present, one becomes more naturally a part of the other. But the addition of artificial intelligence is something entirely different, right? That takes us much closer to our goal of a metaverse of augmented reality, blending physical and digital together, not just in immersive headsets, but also in the physical world, right? So along with the progress that we're making in avatars and in Horizon, it should be clear that we are steadily moving towards that vision of the metaverse that we first laid out here at Connect in 2021. I cannot express to you genuinely enough what a privilege it is to get to work on these next generation of technologies, not just to bring them into existence, but to do so in a way that makes them as accessible as possible to as many people as possible. I want to thank you all for being here today. I can't wait to see what you all build, and I can't wait for what's next. Thank you.